Although we all know that protected areas provide multiple social economic benefits to the humans, and let these pictures from Finland illustrate some of those benefits really briefly. So they provide, protected areas provide fresh water, clean air, conservation of habitats and species, as well as conservation of cultural heritage. They provide food such as berries, mushrooms, fish, game, as well as recreational opportunities and educational opportunities. How to illustrate this in a powerful way so that it appeals to the decision makers as well as the general public who should be supportive of our protected areas? And now I quote Professor Paul Eagles. He has put it very much to the point. He has said that whether we want it or not, governments and societies place more value on that which is measured. So if we look at the total value of a protected area, it consists of many different kinds of values. The most tangible, easiest to measure are the direct use values, such as recreation and scenery. Then there's indirect use values related to water, climate, photos, films, so on. Then we have option values for future uses. And then there's a whole array of less tangible, harder to measure non-use values, like existence value of original nature, species and habitats, as well as bequest or heritage value, if you will. Tackling this kind of task of measuring a really complex set of values can be regarded as an overwhelming task. So what we did in the US Park Service and in Parks and Wildlife Finland, we decided to start from one corner of this figure, tackling a smaller, more concise task of measuring the local economic impacts of national park visitation. So it's part of the direct use values related to recreation. More specifically, what did we do? The US National Park Service got together with researchers quite a while ago, and they developed an application producing annually direct and total income effects in dollars and employment effects measured in jobs full-time equivalent. Those results are produced at the park, regional, state, and national level. Many more years later, Finland benchmarked the US model, and we developed a similar kind of model adapted to Finnish circumstances. It is an easy-to-use, standardized, and practical tool that is based on economic input-output framework. As an input, that model uses three key pieces of information, which is annual number of visits to the parks, visitor spendings in the parks and their surroundings, as well as multipliers describing the flow of money in the local economies. The US National Park has now been measuring and reporting visitor spending and economic effects for a quarter of a century, and in Finland we have been doing so for 5 years now. According to these assessments, in both the United States and in Finland, on average the cost-benefit ratio is 1 to 10. So, for example, in dollars, $1 public investment in national parks results in $10 return to local economies. And in both countries, these results remain highly visible. They are very popular documents annually when they come out, and they have proven to be of great value in local as well as national governmental decision-making, helping the agencies in achieving conservation and development planning tasks. In Finland, the most important use of these figures has been in making the case for continued public investment through illustrating that money spent on management and services of national parks and other protected areas comes back manifold to local economies in terms of private entrepreneurship and jobs. A few years ago, we had a severe budget crisis facing us, like I guess all we have all the time those threats. But that was really a year when our director, Rauno Väisänen, was using these figures, and he said these were one of the key factors that convinced our decision makers at the governmental level that it does not pay back to, it's not a wise decision to cut from money from park management. And in the end, these planned budget cuts were not implemented. You may now have a question of what makes it work? How do we do these calculations? And I would like to emphasize that the basic requirement for calculating visitor spending effects in a national level on a constant way, producing these numbers annually, getting the trends there, is to have a comprehensive standardized visitor monitoring system, including both visitor countings and visitor surveys. So you have to have that input data correct to be able to stand behind your figures. When we started to develop this model in Finland, we already had that kind of visitor monitoring system at place, so it was kind of easy to build and just make a more efficient use of visitor monitoring data by adding up a module on economic impact calculations to that. Even though establishing this kind of comprehensive visitor monitoring system that is in place in both the United States and in Finland National Park takes a lot of resources, but it's very useful, and not only useful, but we have found it as a necessity in order to be able to do successful management decisions, but also to be able to showcase the benefits of the national parks to the society.